this. If someone goes to a court, you've done something serious. Now you are standing in that dock and you are waiting for the jury to come back and deliver their judgment. And then you are waiting for the judge to say, imagine what will go through your heart. That time we'll be thinking to ourselves, our heart will be beating faster. Why? We don't even know if we are going to be put in jail or we're going to be let loose. Now if you know that you are definitely going to go into jail, they're still not going to kill you. In this country, you don't get the death penalty. So at least you will know that you're not going to be put to death. But still, we'll be so fearful. Imagine on the day of judgment when me and you will not even know what our destination will be. Will our destination be the garden of paradise? Or are we going to be dragged into the fire of hell? At that time, my dear Islam, these are the kind of things that we need to remember. And this is what Amir Ahle Sunnah says. This is why he has given us Madani Inamat. May Allah Ta'ala shower His blessings and His mercies upon us. And may we all try to recite as much durood unto the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as possible. Sallu ala al-Habib Sallallahu Ta'ala ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. It's written in Hikayatein aur Nasihatein, page number 132. Hazrat Ahmad Rahmatullahi Ta'ala alayhi, he says, he tells his dream he had. And he says that I saw my servant in the dream. She was a woman. He saw her in the dream. And he says that when I saw her, I said to her, I have not seen any woman more beautiful than you in my life. And she replied, and she says, do you remember that night when he asked this woman, how come you are so beautiful and where did this beauty come from? And that woman, that girl, she replied, do you remember that night when you were crying in the fear of Allah? Them tears which were flowing from your eyes, I took some of them tears and I massaged them on my face. Because of that, you are seeing me in this beautiful state. So how did she get that beauty? By massaging her face with the tears which were falling from the fear of Allah. That tells you what value these tears have. You know, when someone cries in the fear of Allah, because we at that moment in time will be thinking to ourselves, what is he doing? Why is he crying for? A lot of people, when they see, you know, someone crying in the fear of Allah, people tend to have these thoughts, and these thoughts are given by the shaitan. Min sharril waswasil khannas. The shaitan, immediately he will come to us and he will say, what are you crying for? You know, Allah Ta'ala is merciful. Allah Ta'ala can forgive them. But my dear Islam brothers, today I want to talk about why people cry in the fear of Allah and what are the blessings and benefits of crying in the fear of Allah. Now, one waqiyah tells you that this girl, she massaged her face with them tears and Allah Ta'ala made her beautiful. Imagine on the day of judgment what value these tears will have. The hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the mafhum is that the Prophet Sallallahu Ta'ala Alaihi Wasallam, he says, on the day of judgment, a person who will be crying in the fear of Allah, his tears will be enough to extinguish the fire of hell for him. His tears, he's been crying in the fear of Allah, them tears will be enough to extinguish the fire of hell. That is the value. That is how strong these tears will be on the day of judgment. And Allah Azza wa Jal, he says inside the Holy Quran and the tafsir, the commentary, in tafsir Na'imi, Mufti Ahmad Yar Khan Na'imi, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi, he says, to cry whilst listening to the Quran, whilst doing the zikr of Allah, and crying at the time of praising the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a great blessing. One day, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was reciting Surah Al-Takathur, Al-Hakum Al-Takathur, and the companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they were sat around him. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he says, I will recite Surah Al-Takathur. Whoever cries in the fear of Allah whilst listening to the Quran, Allah will make the garden of paradise wajib on him. Some of the Sahaba-i-Kiram, when they were listening to the Quran, they started crying. And some of them who could not cry, they asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayka wa sallam, what will happen to us? Because we cannot cry in the fear of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, I will repeat the same surah again, and whoever cries in the fear of Allah, Jannat will become wajib on him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited surah Takasur again. Three times this happened. And the Sahaba ikram, they said, O Prophet of Allah, what if we cannot cry? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, now there might be someone sahih thinking to themselves, well, I'm in the same situation. I can't cry. People talk about the fear of Allah. People talk about the punishment a person will receive on the day of judgment. Yet I still cannot cry. But my dear Islam brothers, there is still a blessing. There is still a reward from Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, if you cannot cry in the fear of Allah, at least make yourself in a position or make yourself look like as if you are crying in the fear of Allah.